President Marcos shrugging off Chinese President Xi Jinping's reported order to Beijing's military to prepare for conflicts at sea. For Marcos, China's actions already reflect Xi's orders. He adds the Philippines will continue to defend its maritime territory despite China's growing aggression.
Quite frankly, I don't think there's anything new there. That's what they've been doing already. They have defined the 10-dash line, and they continue, in their view, to defend it. We, for our part, continue to defend what we and the international community has recognized as our maritime territory. So, although he did not, the President Xi Jinping did not state that outright until now, that really has been the policy since I think of years already, for the last 2 or 3 years.
Is that
Marcos, meanwhile, confirms he will be meeting with U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken on March 19. Another possible meeting with the U.S. and Japan is being finalized.
The intention is to continue to plan to strengthen the cooperation between the three countries, the United States, Japan, and the Philippines. We will perhaps formalize it, but we at this point, we are still, that's part of the discussion that we will be having to exactly what will be put in any such agreement.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. hits back at his predecessor for criticizing his recent trips abroad. Speaking to reporters in Germany, Marcos said his travels are for business and not for sightseeing. This after former President Rodrigo Duterte claimed the president's overseas trips were mostly for leisure.
Ito yung schedule ko. Saan yung pasyal? This is my schedule for today. Where's the paseo? Wala. You know, yung kasama nyo kami, you know, we don't make pasyal. Even in the places that I know or I've spent a lot of time with, hindi ko napupuntahan yung mga dati kong pinupuntahan because we're here to do this.
The president's visit to Germany was his 24th foreign trip since he assumed office in 2022. It followed his twin visits to Australia. After Germany, Marcos flew to Prague, where he was invited for a 3-day state visit to the Czech Republic. The president's travel budget for this year was raised to 1.4 billion pesos from 893 million pesos in 2023. The International Criminal Court's drug war probe brought up during President Marcos' meeting with German Chancellor Olaf Scholz. Marcos said the German leader asked him about the status of the investigation, and he explained why the Philippines is not recognizing the ICC's jurisdiction. He also informed Scholz his administration has completely changed the Philippine government's anti-drug campaign.
So I think we just wanted to be informed. But I went further beyond just explaining the position of the Philippines in vis-a-vis the ICC. I also went further and said we have actually completely changed the concept of the anti-drug campaign. The enforcement can only take you so far, and we have taken it as far as we can, and maybe in the opinion of some we've taken it beyond. So kailangan natin tignan is the prevention and the rehabilitation, which is I think a different approach.
The Philippines ended its ties with the ICC in March 2019 upon the orders of former President Rodrigo Duterte. Philippine House lawmakers are set to approve on final reading next week a resolution amending economic provisions of the country's charter. RG Cruz reports.
Speaker, I now move that we approve on second reading RBH number 7. So move.
All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All those against, say nay. The ayes have it. Resolution of both houses, number 7, is hereby approved on second reading.
With this vote, the House of Representatives approved on second reading resolution of both houses number 7 to revise the 1987 Charter to empower Congress to legislate foreign investment caps on public utilities, education, and advertising. A crucial vote that brings the measure a step closer to final approval and ends all plenary debates. About 6 lawmakers interpellated sponsors of the measure on Tuesday and Wednesday, repeating points already discussed during the Committee of the Whole proceedings. The House leadership renewed assurances that the two chambers will vote separately on final approval.
Baka sa pagkakataon na hindi talaga mag-cooperate ang Senate, then because you are the bigger house and we have the numbers to approve charter change, then pwedeng maabot yung 3/4 of the whole Congress, kahit na house lang po yung gumalaw.
The sponsor and all in the leadership, including Speaker Romualdez, is for a separate voting. The Senate votes, the House will vote. And so therefore, that is what will be done. We are not going to approve this without the Senate.
There is also a way to reconcile differences between the Senate and House versions of economic charter change without any bicameral panel, foreclosing any further amendments outside of the 3 originally proposed.
Dadaan ba sa bicameral conference committee ang RBH number 7? Halimbawa, may pagkakaibang laman ng House of Representatives at Senate.
The way to do this, to be able to have an understanding, is for us to ratify the RBH 6 of the Senate, or for them to approve ours and accept them and ratify them. So there is a way to be able to make our 2 Congresses agree to one particular provision, no need for a conference committee.
Ang tatanong talaga nila sa atin, yan ba ay maglalagay o sa mga nasa kapangyarihan na ngayon na muli pa ulit mailagay dyan? Yun ang tanong nila eh, Mr. Speaker. So
yes, but
with this revisions, Mr. Speaker, sinasabi niyo po na hindi. Na walang ganon.
Very clear. That is only economic amendments, 3 provisions, nothing more, nothing less.
Top House economist Marikina 2nd District Representative Stella Kimbo explained economic cha-cha will not only give flexibility to policy lawmakers, but it will also remove uncertainty for businessmen.
When there is something that needs to be changed, as in the case of public utilities, ang nangyayari po is we attempt to correct it by way of legislation, like what we did with the Public Service Act. Ang nangyayari po is na-challenge po sa Supreme Court, and that's the one that causes uncertainty in the business sector. Yun po yung gusto natin ma-avoid. And so by finally doing Econ Chacha, we are number one, introducing flexibility, and number two, we are reducing uncertainty. We are taking away the possibility of challenges in the Supreme Court.
The majority did not make any changes to RBH 7 prior to approval, which will now be up for final approval by 3/4 vote next week. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
Meanwhile, House lawmakers approve on second reading a bill seeking to revoke the franchise of controversial TV network SMNI due to alleged violations. The measure will be ripe for final approval next week, but it still needs a go-ahead from the Senate. SMNI is the broadcast media arm of the Davao-based Church of Televangelist Apollo Quiboloy. But the religious leader had repeatedly refused to attend the committee hearings, prompting lawmakers to cite him in contempt.
These are just delaying tactics. Even though na mag-hearing na naman tayo next, iba na namang rason ang ibibigay. Mag-hearing na naman tayo ikapitong hearing, ibang rason na naman. When will this be concluded?
Alam po ninyo, yung the mere fact na nagbigay pa rin ng palugit ng committee ng tatlong araw on the request of Attorney Topazio just shows you kung gano'ng kaluwag ang committee sa pagbibigay po ng lahat ng request nila. Maski na po sa 5 buwan, minsan hindi dumating si Pastor Quiboloy, inimbitahan po siya 4 beses, ay pinagbigyan pa rin na on the special request of Attorney Topacio na bigyan po hanggang Biyernes. So talaga ho lahat ho ng pagbibigay at luwag ay binigay po namin during the five-month hearing.
The owner of the controversial resort near Bohol's Chocolate Hills speaks up. The manager, Julieta Sablas, says they were issued the necessary permits for the construction of the resort. But she admitted they failed to get an environmental compliance certificate, or ECC.
Aware na po kami na protected area, pero meron namang mga dapat muna gawin para mabigyan po kayo ng clearance para i-allow po yung mga construction niyo po. Pero meron po kaming lapses po yung ECC po, Environmental Compliance Certificate po. Hindi po namin na nagawa ng paraan na ipaprocess muna namin.
Opo.
Pero yung sa mga construction po, no, talagang may permit po kami sa LGU. Sila lang po ang nagsabi na nakakasira. Pero pag talagang nandito po kayo sa area namin, talagang hindi po eh. Sana before po yung mga negative comments niyo po, mas mabuti siguro magtanong-tanong muna tayo kung talagang meron po kami nilabag na sinisira po namin yung mga Chocolate Hills po.
The Environment Department earlier said it had ordered the temporary closure of the resort last year for operating without an ECC. The resort drew flak online due to its proximity to the world-renowned Chocolate Hills, which were declared a protected area in 1997. For Bohol's Natural Resources and Environmental Protection Committee, the DNR needs to clear what it called ambiguities in its guidelines.
In this case, pwede lang na 20% of the area from the baseline to the tip of the hill lang daw yung pwede po nilang galawin for development. 20% is relative, 20% is subjective. Kung mataas ang hill, mataas din yung nagagamit po natin doon sa area. We strongly advise PAMBI to revise that guideline. We want na dun mismo sa area na yon, hindi po siya dapat na may development.
The Captain's Peak Garden and Resort is now voluntarily closing. In an advisory released last night, the resort said it will comply with the directives of the Environment Department for maintenance and environmental preservation efforts. It adds the closure will give them time to implement various eco-friendly initiatives to further enhance the sustainability of the resort. Malacañang gives the media a look at a newly renovated mansion that will be used as a guest house for visiting world leaders. Katrina Domingo has this story.
From a 95-year-old stale property inside the Malacañang compound, the La Peral Mansion has been given a facelift, ready to receive world leaders who are in the country to do business with the Philippine president. Its neoclassical facade repainted, its roof repaired, the wooden floors repolished, and its 14 bedrooms named after the Philippines' former presidents, with each design telling a story about their life and personality.
It's something that we're proud of, and it's something that we want to show and to share with everyone. So we feel that this is what better way to show the different presidents with the different artists and the designers of the Philippines, and to showcase it in a place like this.
Anton Barreto and his team worked on the room dedicated to former president and now Pampanga representative Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. He says they sourced the furniture and some decor from her home province in Pampanga, with the 14th president even donating one of her published books as an added touch to the space.
So it worked out perfectly because we know her well and we've done a couple of rooms in her house in the past. So this was easy for us. Ma'am is also known to be very hospitable, and the pineapple is the international sign of hospitality.
Other designers incorporated the hobbies of previous presidents in their designs, such as Benigno Aquino III's penchant for recreational firing, Carlos P. Garcia's acumen in chess, and the iconic yellow ribbons that were popular during the time of Corazon Aquino.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has yet to get a suite here in the La Peral Mansion named after him. But the largest room here is named after his father and namesake Ferdinand Marcos Sr. The size of this room is almost equivalent to three rooms, as it has a sitting room, a bedroom, a walk-in closet, a bathroom with a bathtub, and a balcony.
Lifestyle consultant Tanya Frica-Lechauco played with different Philippine fabrics to deliver an elegant tropical vibe for the Manuel El Quezon suite.
Being part of a project like this, bringing culture and heritage to life, being proud of who we are as a people is something that me personally as a decorator felt so privileged to be part of.
While the pool is part of the original design, an in-house spa was included in this upgraded version.
We're known for hospitality and having a really relaxing and pleasant stay. I know that everyone that will be here will be very stressed and have a lot of work, that we would extend a little bit of this home feeling. We wanted this to be a place that they can relax and they can feel at home when they're not in their own country.
Zobel says the rehabilitation of the La Peral Mansion is an investment, since it will eventually help the government save taxpayers' money when hosting heads of states in Manila. According to Malacanang, the Philippine government usually shells out between 300,000 and 600,000 pesos a night when hosting world leaders here for a state visit. The government will supposedly save more from food costs as meals in the La Peral Mansion will be prepared by Malacanang's in-house team.
It also costs us a lot to rent rooms in hotels for presidential suites, so this actually in the end saves us money.
And it goes back to the government. There's
no shell out anymore.
Zobel clarifies that the La Peral Mansion is only reserved for visiting heads of states and foreign embassies celebrating their respective national days. However, due to security reasons, the property will not be open to the public, unlike the three other Malacañang mansions that were also rehabilitated under the Marcos Jr. administration. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.
Now let's get an update on the weather from Pag-asa forecaster Chanel Dominguez. Hi, Chanel.
Good morning, Bettina. Good morning to everyone. As of now, we are not monitoring any low-pressure area or tropical cyclone within and outside our Philippine area of responsibility. However, Shearland will bring a cloudy sky with scattered rain showers and thunderstorm over Aurora, Quezon, and Camarines Norte. Expect a cloudy sky with light rains over Cagayan Valley and Cordillera Administrative Region. Expect a partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated light rains in the Ilocos Region and the rest of our central Luzon due to the northeast monsoon. However, here in Metro Manila and the rest of our country, expect a generally fair weather with the chances of localized thunderstorm during the afternoon and the evening. That's the latest here in Pag-asa Weather Forecasting Center. Chanel Dominguez, and good morning.
Thank you very much for that update, Chanel.